Hello everyone, I, Komal Gangi, Faculty of MBA from Technia Institute of Advanced Studies. Today, I'm going to deliver a lecture on controlling. Control is one of the major functions of management. In the earlier lectures, we have discussed the various other functions of management. And today, the topic of discussion would be control, the relevance of control function, the characteristics and the importance of control function. So, you must have come across statements like control your anger, control your expenses, save money, control your kids, etc. In common language, what control means to check or verify, to regulate, to curb or restrain, etc. In the context of business, it means a process of controlling the activities of the organization. A good definition of control is that it is a process through which managers assure that actual activities conform to the planned activities. Control is directly related to planning. It ensures that plans are implemented properly. In the management cycle functions, with planning, organizing, directing and controlling, planning moves forward to all other functions and controlling is the last function. This is because control is the final link in the function chain of management activities. It is the only way managers know whether or not organizational goals are being met, why or why not they are being met. Thus, the objective of the topic is to make the students understand the concept of control so as to enable them to get an insight about what kind of control system would work best in a given situation. The managerial control implies that measurement of accomplishment against the standard and the correction of deviation, if any, to assure attainment of objectives according to the plans. This definition was given by Coons and O'Donnell. A fundamental managerial function that follows other functions, control is a continuous process of management. By forcing events to conform to plans, control becomes intimately connected with planning and has the same characteristics of unity of continuity, flexibility and pervasiveness as are possessed by planning. Controlling as a function of management therefore means the measurement and correction of performance of activities of subordinates in order to make sure that enterprise objectives and plans devised to attain them are accomplished. So control does consist in knowing the extent to which actions are in conformity with the plans adopted and instructions issued so that the errors and deviations are promptly reported and analyzed and suitable corrective action could be taken. Remedial actions may result in alteration of plans, change in the organization structure, modification in the staffing process or change in the process and techniques of direction. Now I'll be discussing about the various characteristics of control. Now control depends on and contributes to other functions of management. Without plans to set objectives and specify activities, control would serve no useful purpose. Without organizations, there would hardly be any guidance about who should make evaluations and who should take care of the corrective action. In the absence of effective direction, corrective action would have little or insignificant impact on actual performance. Thus, different phases of management process need to be effectively linked together. Control presupposes the existence of goals and plans. Accordingly, no manager can control actions which are not planned. Thus, complete and coordinated plans greatly facilitate the control process. Now, secondly, control pervades at all levels of management. In view of the authority vested in the managers occupying top positions in the organization and their consequent responsibility, control is sometimes considered to be the function of top management. And many are under the impression that little control is needed at lower levels. But this is erroneous and misleading. Although the nature of control exercised by the manager varies, it is an essential function of management performed at all levels in the organization. Controlling is a function of every manager in the organization, right from the chairman or the board of directors down to the first line supervisor. For example, top management is involved in exercising strategic control, middle management concentrates on tactical control, and operational control is the responsibility of supervisory management. Now, thirdly, control is forward-looking. A manager cannot control the past. A manager can take corrective action only about the future operations. By reviewing the past events, a manager applies the advantages of previous experience to future corrections. Control is usually preventive, as presence of control system tends to minimize wastages, losses, and deviations from standards. Now, fourthly, control is a continuous activity. It is not a one-step process, but a continuous process. It involves constant revision and analysis of standards resulting from the deviations between actual and planned performance. Now, the next characteristic is that the purpose of control is positive. Control serves a positive purpose, both at the organizational level as well as the individual level. The purpose of control is to make things happen, that is to achieve organizational goals within stated constraints or by means of planned activities. And at the individual level, the purpose of control is to make individuals give up a part of their independence so that common goal and objectives may be accomplished. Now, we'll be discussing about the importance of control. It is through a well-designed control system that the managers regulate the activities of individuals and units so that they are consistent with the goals and standards of the organization. Control is important, therefore, because it is the only way managers know whether organizational goals are being met and if not, the reasons why they are not met. The value of the control function can be judged from the various benefits that accrue from it. The value of the control function can be judged from the following major benefits that accrue from it. Like, it helps in decentralizing authority. An efficient system of control encourages top management to go in for decentralization of authority. With controls, managers can foster decision making at lower levels without losing ultimate control. It increases managerial ability to cope with uncertainty and change. Now, you know, uncertainty and change are an inevitable part of any organization's environment. By developing control systems, managers are better able to monitor specific activities and react quickly to significant changes in the environment. This facilitates organizational viability in the face of environmental uncertainty and change, especially in such areas as customer demand, technology, availability of raw materials, and government regulations. Control strives to rationally structure human behavior. Since most organizational activities ultimately depend on human behavior, controlling is largely geared towards highlighting needed behavior and discouraging unwanted behavior. Thus, control infuses order, discipline, and purposefulness among organizational participants to improve the predictability of their behavior, to reduce diversity, and to bring forth unity of effort in their performance. Control ensures effective use of scarce and valuable resources. It minimizes the variability in the use of resources so that intended goals are achieved with the least cost and a few untoward consequences. Now, control facilitates coordination. I would say control and coordination are important processes of management. In the context of predetermined goals, control keeps all activities and efforts within their fixed boundaries and makes them to move towards common goals through coordinated activities. In this sense, control pulls together all the diverse multiple threads of organized activity and weaves them into a unified system to achieve predetermined goals. Thus, control is a feeder function to ensure and maintain coordination throughout the organization. With this, I hope you all have understood the topic of control, its importance, and the characteristics. Thank you very much.